We finally watched Sonic Prime Season 3 all the way through. Honestly, I was decently surprised, which is very surprising because a lot of people thought Season 1 and 2 of Sonic Prime were way better than Season 3. Myself, vice versa, I thought Season 1 and 2 were terrible, and I literally complained here on my YouTube channel, and I myself was very surprised by Season 3. First off, why I hated the show to begin with was because I felt like it was very childish, nowhere near emotional like Sonic X was. If you did not know already, the reason why I'm even a YouTuber of Sonic and I'm making this video today was because of the show Sonic X. That is the reason why I became a Sonic fan the way I am. So I was decently surprised by Season 3 of Sonic Prime. As I said already, I hated the first and second season, and the third one honestly was not that bad. Just a warning, this is going to be a spoiler alert. I am going to be talking a lot about Sonic Prime Season 3, what I witnessed of this, and if you have not seen Season 3, you may want to click off the video right now. But if not, let's continue on with the video. So Season 3, I saw a lot of things of these characters that were very surprising to me. I would have not expected for any of these characters to have gone through what they did. Now, a lot of people may argue that Sonic Prime is not canon to the overall franchise. However, the same exact thing can be said about a lot of other TV shows of Sonic, like Sonic Boom. That is honestly the perfect example of not canon. However, if you look at the definition of canon, basically means it's official and happened within the franchise. So regardless of what show you look at or video game of Sonic, if it happened officially in content that was released by Team Sonic or Sega, it is honestly canon, which I hope might put an end to the overall arguments that go on whether it is canon or not. So a lot of these characters went through things that I would have never expected in the Sonic franchise, starting with Shadow the Hedgehog eating dirt. Literally got punched by one of Nine's minions and basically flew across and fell into a trench, and gave me the idea that Shadow died in the first episode, Season 3 of Sonic Prime. However, he made a comeback later in the season. Now, the second thing I also wanted to mention that surprised me a lot was just the overall dynamic of Sonic and Shadow. Typically, Shadow opposes Sonic and he kind of does his own thing. He doesn't take orders from nobody. However, it looks like he was just a friend trying to help out. He knew Sonic messed up and he was trying to help. What I want to really talk about in today's video is the finale of Sonic Prime. If you've been a supporter of the channel, you will know that we talked all about Sonic Prime and we said that Season 3 was going to be the last. And if you paid attention to the ending of this show, it definitely feels like this is going to be the last of Sonic Prime that we see. Going back to what I said is very controversial. I feel like half the people hate the show, and I see no reboots of this show in the near future. However, if we look at shows like Sonic X, which in my opinion ended on a very good note, still have not made a return to this very day. Sonic Prime getting a reboot, or of course a continuation, is quite unlikely if you ask me. Throughout the whole Season 3 of Sonic Prime, Nine became the overall bad guy, as he was trying to hoard the Paradox Prism to create his own world known as the Grim. In Nine's defense, Sonic was basically using him to get back home to restore Green Hill. So I definitely empathized throughout the whole Season 3 for Nine and about where he was coming from. And then, to no surprise, the Eggman Council teamed up with Sonic the Hedgehog as per usual.
So brave, so powerless. Bring him to me!
Hey, bird brains! Get off my lawn! This is where you shank us, you miserable rodent!
You're helping me?
Helping? More like using. We need your energy.
For what?
We'll talk later. Plus, if we don't stop this crazy fox, New York City and us won't be around for much longer.
In all of Sonic content, Eggman usually is the bad guy and he ends up teaming up with Sonic the Hedgehog and friends. And the same exact thing happened where they felt like they had no choice. At the ending, we had the switch up. Once they retrieved the Paradox Prism, the Eggman Council turned their back right away, which in my opinion, that's where things got really spicy. If you watch the ending of Sonic Prime, Sonic was basically in a very weak state. He was not able to do anything as he was useless. That's when when the Eggman Council decided to turn their backs, saying that the Paradox Prism was theirs. And that got me very invested and super interested of what was about to happen. However, I was quickly disappointed as soon as they started arguing with each other. And as they were arguing with each other, Sonic and friends decided to kick them through a portal where they were unable to do anything further. And then after that, Sonic went back home, no problems whatsoever. And that's when I was truly disappointed, because just as the show got good, it got boring really fast. And if you've seen this, definitely let me know in the comments down below, what do you feel about this? Because to be honest, I was impressed up until this point. However, there's definitely something else about this season that I want to talk about. And this is also an issue throughout the overall show, Sonic Prime. So if you watched any season of Sonic Prime, you will know most of the show consists of fighting scenes. And me as a Sonic fan coming from Sonic X, I'm more interested about the character development as well as the relationships, especially relationships like Knux Ooge. I absolutely love the dynamic of Knuckles and Rouge, and I was stoked before the first season of Sonic Prime came out of Knux Ooge. However, I was quickly disappointed season 1, 2, and 3 when Knuckles and Rouge were only partners for work rather than partners in relationship. And that definitely also was a very big disappointment of Sonic Prime for me and deterred me from liking the entire series. So in conclusion, I believe season 3 definitely was better, which is a huge surprise because most people actually did not like season 3. And for season 1 and 2, I was on the opposite end. However, I still think Sonic X was a far better TV show, especially the Japanese dub. And I feel like Sonic X still remains as a more emotional, dark show. And I much prefer Sonic X than Sonic Prime to this very day. And I feel like a lot of people can definitely relate to that as well. I'm not completely trashing on Sonic Prime. I definitely think this show is for certain people out there. And as a Sonic fan myself, to be honest, I'm not entirely upset with Sonic Prime. However, I feel like, and I've said this many times before, Team Sonic and Sega tend to stay away from the dark and edgy lore and story. Well, anyways, guys, if you enjoyed the video, be sure you drop a like. Also, subscribe to the channel because we post quality content on a consistent basis. And I want to thank all of you guys for tuning in today, and we will see you guys on the next video or live stream.